Good morning students, welcome to online teaching session of Academic World School once again. Today we will be starting a new chapter, chapter 4, Metals and Non-Metals of Grade 8 Science. Today we will be studying the physical properties of metals. Do you know what this physical property means? Physical properties is basically looking into anything and understanding about that particular thing, whether it is an object, a living thing or non-living thing. By looking into it only or by touching physically, these are the physical properties. If you will look around yourself, you will observe that there are so many things and they are made up of different materials. Some are very hard, some are solid, some are liquid and some are in gaseous state. Some are very soft, some can be compressed, some cannot be compressed. These are the physical properties of those substances. In this chapter today, we will be discussing about the metals. Before that, I want to discuss the actual concept of the metals. There is no specific definition for the metals, but metals can be identified on the basis of certain properties, physical properties and chemical properties. Today we will discuss the physical properties. There are certain physical properties of metals on the basis of which we can identify any material, whether it is a metal or a non-metal. Like, here are the physical properties, the physical state, whether the object is solid, liquid or gas, appearance, how is it look, luster, malleability, ductility, sonority, conductivity, hardness and density. Today we will be discussing all these properties of metals. First we will start with the physical state. So children, most of the metals, their physical state is solid. It means most of the metals are solid. Mostly, metals are found in only one physical state, that is solid. They are found in solid state. But exception is there. Only one metal is there, mercury. Mercury is the only metal which is found in liquid state. You might have seen that one dark colored liquid is present in thermometer. When we go to the doctor, they used to show us a thermometer. Inside that something is there which rises up to show the increase in temperature. That is mercury. It is a metal, but still it appears in liquid state. So mercury is the exceptional case. Otherwise all the metals are found in solid state. Physical state means matter. All the matter has three states: solid, liquid and gas. Mostly all the metals, again I am repeating, they are solid in state except of mercury. Mercury is in liquid state. I hope, like every time, you might have taken out your notebook and start writing all the properties and along with the exceptions. Second property is appearance. How the metals look like. Normally, if we will look the different metals like iron, gold, silver, copper, aluminium, you might have seen that they appear different. Generally, they are grayish in color. But few metals are there like gold. Gold is yellowish in color and copper. Copper is reddish. It is about their color, but they have their specific shine, and on the basis of that only it becomes easy for us to identify which one is gold and which one is silver, which one is copper, which is iron, which is aluminium, stainless steel. In our home also, if you will look into your kitchen, if you will look into your windows, you will see that many of the things are made up of metals and their color is different. The jewelry that your mom wears, its color is different from the rod which is made up of iron. On that basis, on the basis of the color, you can identify the gold, copper, silver, aluminium and other metals. Next is lustrous. Luster means shine. Shine. Now see, as I told, we can very easily identify the gold on the basis of its color. So it is not only the color, all the metals, they have their own specific shine, and that is known as luster. All the metals are lustrous. Sometimes you might come across certain metals which do not shine. It is not the actual concept. Sometimes it happens that due to the air or due to dust, it happens that on any of the metal, like for example, if this is a metal, it is coming across the dust particles and the outer covering is completely covered with the dust, and due to that it appears dull. But when we will again rub it, after rubbing the iron or any other metal, whatever it is, its shine will again appear. So all the metals, they have their own specific shine. On the basis of that, we can say that all the metals are lustrous. The property is known as luster, and metals are lustrous. If we talk about the metals, we can say metals are lustrous in nature. They have their own specific shine. Gold is having different kind of shiny color. Silver have different shiny color, and copper has different shiny color. Stainless steel has different shiny color. And on the basis of that, we can very easily identify among all the metals which is gold, which is silver, which is copper, which is iron, which is aluminium in this way. The next property is malleability. Now see, if you will hammer a piece of brick, like if this is a piece of brick, and if you will hammer it, what will happen? You will observe that it will break. It will break from certain places and it will be changed into different pieces, and you can find some powdery mass also there. But in case of metal, for example, if this piece of material is made up of iron or aluminium, do you think same thing will happen? No. If we will hammer it, you will observe that the thickness will decrease, it will compress and its width will increase. And finally, after beating it again, we will find that it is now converted into thin sheet in this way. This property of metals are known as malleability. Means, metals can be hammered into thin sheets. And due to this property only, different kinds of utensils you have seen at your home, you can find, and due to this property only, they can be made into those containers. First the thin sheets are made, and then those sheets are given the specific shape for making the glass, utensils and the other things. So the most important property are these. Out of this malleability is the most commonly used property of metals. All the metals, almost all the metals can be hammered into thin sheets so that they can be used for making different objects. The next property is ductility. All the metals, on giving a specific amount of heat, a specific temperature, they start melting. And after melting, the metals can be drawn into wires this way. You can see that the net are present, net we use for making different things. In windows also nowadays we are using net, and these wires are used for making electrical wires also made up of copper. All these wires are made up of metals, and this property of making thin wires after melting the metal, this property is called as ductility. It means metals can be melted and drawn into thin wires. Almost all the metals can be melted and they can be drawn into thin wires. This property is used for making the rods also, even though it appears very thick for us. But due to the same property, these rods are made, and thin wires, very thin wires, are made of gold also to make different beautiful designs of gold jewelries. If you will observe the chain and the different jewelries of your mom, you will observe that very fine wires are there, and by using those wires only, different designs are made in the gold jewelry. Look into the jewelries that are present. You can ask your mom to show at least one jewelry to you, and you can find that it is also made up of some fine wires. So, ductility is the property of metal by which metals can be melted and drawn into thin wires. The next property is sonority. Sonority means producing a ringing sound. Like, see, if we will stop one metallic object with one metallic spoon like this, then what will happen? A ringing sound will come. That ringing sound is known as sonorous sound, and that property is known as sonority. So all the metals have sonority. It means they produce ringing sound. When struck by any object. And due to this property only, the bells in the temple are made up of metals. It is not made up of wood or plastic or anything else, because metals are more sonorous than something else, other materials. And the sonority among all the metals, there are so many metals like iron, gold, copper, sodium, potassium, aluminium, platinum. Now see, the sonority of the metals are different among each other also. The sound produced by gold is different from the sound produced by the copper, by brass, by stainless steel, or by iron. Now see here, stainless steel is not a metal, it is an alloy. But it has the properties of metals also. Conductivity. Next property of metals are conductivity. Now see, metals are good conductor. They are good conductor of heat as well as electricity. Good conductor means what? They allow the heat and electricity to pass through them. For example, if this is made up of metal, if we will heat from this side, after some time we will observe that this part also becomes hot. It happens in the metals only. But if we will try to heat this marble, which is made up of plastic, what will happen? If we will supply heat from this side, we will observe that it starts melting from here, but this end is not at all hot. Why? Because it is bad conductor of heat, and it does not allow the heat to pass from this side to go this side. But in case of metals, if we will have one iron rod or any of the rod, whether it is a gold, copper, silver, iron, any metal, if we will supply heat from this side, then after some time we will observe that this rod becomes heated, and the heat is passing from this side to this side, and after some time up to this also the rod becomes hot. This side also becomes hot. This is because metals are good conductor of heat. The same thing happened with the electricity also. The metals, all the metals allow the electricity to pass through them, and due to that only the wires, electric wires, are made up of metals. And because they are good conductor of heat, all the cooking utensils, they are also made up of metals. Otherwise, if it would be made up of non-metal, what will happen? If we will try to cook food, after some time we will see that if the container If this is the container in which we are cooking food, the container will not pass the heat. If the heat is coming from the any of the heating device, this container, it will not allow the heat to pass into the food and we will not be able to cook our food. To avoid such situation only, the cooking utensils, they are made up of metals because they are good conductor of heat. They allow the electricity to pass through them very easily. Hope you are understanding all the properties of the metals. The next is hard. As in the beginning, in the first property, we have told that metals are found in solid state. And in grade 6, you had studied about the molecular arrangement of solid, liquid and gas. In solids, the atoms are placed closely to each other. There is no space for them to move around. You can see in this way, these are the circles that I have made. They are representing the atoms present in any of the metal, any of the solid. Now in case of liquid, the molecules are apart from each other and they can very easily move because they are getting empty spaces to move freely. This is about the solid, this is about the liquid. But in case of gas, there are a much distance and much space to move around and gases can very easily move from their place. The atoms can very easily move from their place. But here, what we had a talk? We had discussed that all the metals are in solid state. It means their atomic arrangement are like this. Now, due to this situation, metals are very hard because their atoms are closely packed to each other and in between the atoms, interatomic attraction force is very high. They are bounded with each other with a very great force and due to that, they cannot move from one place to another. They are very hard. All the metals, they are generally hard. Generally hard and they have high tensile strength. But exception is here also. Two metals are there which are not hard as mercury is in liquid state. So it doesn't show this property. It is not that much hard. Along with that, sodium and potassium. These two are the metals which are very soft. They can be even cut with a knife very easily, like we cut vegetables and fruits. In the same way, this sodium and potassium can also be very easily cut with the help of knife. Other than these three, mercury, sodium and potassium, all the metals are very hard and they have very high tensile strength. And due to this reason only, metals are only used for making the hard things. Like vehicles are made up of metals, bridges are made up of metals, trains, aeroplanes, all these things which are supposed to bear load, heavy load on them, they are made up of mostly metals. Otherwise, if those things which are very soft in those would have been used, they will not go for a longer time and they will not be able to bear those heavy loads on them. And due to that only, the bridges which are made up of metals, iron especially, they can bear a large number of vehicles moving above the bridges. The next is density. Density is the number of atoms in 1 cubic centimeter, density. They are very hard and just now I have showed by the diagram also that in solid state, the molecular arrangement or the atomic arrangement, in that atomic arrangement I have shown that atoms are closely packed to each other and due to that their density is very high. Very high density. they cannot melt easily by giving a small amount of heat. If we want to melt the metals, a very high amount of heat, the temperature can be raised very high to melt the metals. Now see, this is all about the physical properties of the metals. Now you can understand that by looking or by touching, by looking into the things only, we can understand about the metals. We can very easily identify whether the object is made up of metal or a non-metal. For example, if I will ask about this marker, then I have to identify whether it is a made up of metal or non-metal. Then what I have to do? I have to cross-check these properties against this marker. First with the physical state, whether it is solid, yes, it is solid. Then appearance, is it grayish, yellowish, copper color, no. Then luster, yes or no, yes or no, yes or no. Like that, we have to coincide. If any of the object is having most of the properties of metals, then we can include that object under the category of metals. Now see, if we will discuss the property, we had already discussed the properties of the metals, but you know, in these properties also, they are different in each other, like conductivity, hardness, density. All the metals are hard, all the metals conduct electricity, but their conductivity is different. Some metals are very, very, very good conductor of electricity. Some metals are conductor, but they are not excellent conductor of electricity. Okay? You can understand why only copper or aluminium is used for making the electrical wires. Why not iron is used? Only because copper is far better conductor than iron. Although iron is also the conductor of electricity, but copper is more conductor. It allows electricity very freely to pass. And it is more ductile than iron. These are the properties. If we will talk about the malleability among the metals also, they are different. Different metals have different malleability. They have different ductility. Sonority is different. Conductivity is different. But all these properties are common in all the metals. And due to that only, different metals are used for making different things. A specific metal is taken to make a specific thing. Like iron is used for making the rods, bridges, buildings, and even vehicles. But copper is not used for making bridges. Why? Due to the certain properties of iron, which are different from the copper. It is more malleable, it is softer than iron. Iron is more harder than copper, and due to that. So in this way, these are all about the properties, physical properties of metals. In the next class, we will be discussing the physical properties of non-metals. Now students, listen to me carefully. Assignments related to this topic is already uploaded in the ERP. Please log into it and do the assignment. See you soon. Thank you.